didn't mean to. Why are you still up here?
I just wanted to start tidying things. We'll never sell this house in the state that it's in.
Come downstairs. I'll make you a nice cup of tea.
It's all right. I want to get started.
Surely this can at least wait until morning.
Help me move these boxes.
Come on. Forget about this place. Let's go downstairs.
You know me, Callum. Once I've set my mind to something...
Demi, forget it. I'll never be able to clean it all alone.
Which is why I've asked you to help me. Do you know what your problem is, Callum? You are allergic to a bit of hard work.
Fine. Do what you want. You usually do.
Where are you going?
Downstairs. I'll leave you too. It's only a dead mouse. He's not going to hurt you.
That explains noises I've been hearing up here. Must be an infestation.
I'd hardly call one dead mouse an infestation. What is that?
It's a letter.
To whom?
I don't know. It's only the first page, but there must be more. What is this?
I don't know. Does it even matter?
Of course it matters. By the time you read this, I shall be dead.
Does it say who wrote it?
I don't know. That must be on page 2. It gets worse. Look at this line. I must accept the judgment for what I've done.
It's a suicide note.
It's not a suicide note. It's a confession. Read it.
I'd rather not.
I knew it. I always thought I had a vibe about this place.
You've never said anything like that in your life.
I suppose there's no point phoning the police now. It was written a very long time ago.
How do you know?
It said somewhere. Here, at the start. By the time you read this, I shall be dead. As the bells ring 1900 in, they shall be the last I ever hear.
I think that's enough for one night.
It all started days before with the gift. But that gift would soon become a curse. I didn't hear you enter.
Well, that was my plan.
What is this?
A necklace.
I can see that. What is it for? Oh,
it's a gift. And before you ask, does there need to be a reason?
Thank you. It's beautiful. You're in a particularly good mood tonight. Oh,
and why wouldn't I be? Business is booming, and I have a rather desirable wife.
Rather?
Fine, sorry. A most beautiful and desirable wife. That's all a man needs in life, really.
It's good to see you smile again. It has been a long time.
I know. And I'm sorry for what I put you through. I really am. I know our marriage didn't start off particularly well.
Yes. But it's all in the past now, love.
Yes, it is. Oh, there's no need to dwell on the past, is there? I feel in the mood for celebration. We're back on top, and this time nothing is going to bring us down.
You were up late last night.
Was I?
Yes. You didn't come to bed.
I couldn't sleep.
Are you worried about selling the house?
I suppose I am, but...
Go on then. Tell me what's really troubling you. You've been on edge for days.
Nothing.
Tell me.
haven't here? There must be more to that letter somewhere.
Timmy, you're starting to worry me now. You've read a page of something written over 100 years ago, and now... I thought we got rid of the dead mouse.
I'm not joking. Listen to me. I'm starting to sound crazy. Perhaps I am crazy.
You're not making any sense.
Since I found that first page, things have been happening.
What things?
Just little things, you know, but doors shutting and hearing noises and all sorts.
Nessa was saying there's a ghost. Do you mean a ghost?
No. Maybe I don't know what I mean.
Has this letter really got you that spooked?
It could just be my mind playing tricks. I don't know, I'm not saying that is. I'm just saying, sometimes, when you're not around, it feels like there's something else in the house.
You're right. It has to be your mind playing tricks. What else could it be?
I don't know, but I can't believe I'm saying this. I've just wondered if by finding that letter sitting there, undisturbed after all this time...
That you managed to disturb some unseen force?
Possibly, or maybe whoever wrote the letter wants me to find the remaining pages? I don't know!
Demi, listen to me. Whatever happened here finished a long time ago. There are no ghosts. That would be the heater kicking on.
That is another thing. Haven't you noticed how much colder it is in this house?
That's probably due to the fact that you spend all of your time in this attic. Also, don't forget, winter is coming.
What do you mean?
Winter is coming. That's what Mr. Abinshaw said. Times are hard at the bank right now, and sacrifices must be made. That's what the metaphor meant.
What sort of sacrifices?
There's no need to worry. Honestly, we'll be fine.
That's what you said before.
I'm not trying to panic you. We just need to be prepared.
Prepared for what?
Things are going to be tight just for a few months. It's a temporary situation due to the current climate. I will let you know when we really need to worry.
Do you promise?
On my life. It's getting late.
Sleep well.
And what are you going to do?
I think I'll do a bit of writing. You know how it helps clear my thoughts. It's very therapeutic.
Always the poet. Everything will be all right. You'll see. Winter won't be as bad as you think.
Gales take hold of your soul, and you wait for the world to swallow you whole. And when the sign of the time is beyond your control, spare a thought for me. When you're hoping and praying for a deep blue sky, the cold still continues. There's just no reply. When you feel so afraid that you swear you may die, spare a thought for me. Yes. Spare a thought for me.
Your father's death.
Thank you.
So, what brings you here?
It's a short stay. I shan't be here more than a day or so.
Good. Good. But why?
To see my dear cousin. Of course, I know it is simply dreadful of me to drop by unannounced, but it was a last minute decision.
Well, it's nice to see you again.
Yes, you too. I shan't be a moment. I've just remembered something. You can at least ask, please, to see me.
Oh, please. Please, we agreed. We had agreed to keep our distance.
What can I say? The agreement has changed. I'm not going to tell her. If that's what you're worried about.
So, then what is your game? Why are you really here?
I couldn't stay away any longer.
Oh, stop that! She could walk in at any moment!
Isn't that exciting?
Look, I told you last month, it's over between us. There's only so many business trips I can pretend to have.
Look at me! I told you you hadn't seen the last of me! Did you think I'd just slip away?
What happened between us was a mistake. Oh, my wife could never know. It would kill her if she knew what we had done.
Your reputation would take quite a knock if a little secret ever got out.
So, then what is it you want? Oh no, please don't tell me you spent all the money I gave you already.
That pittance you gave me could hardly buy the clothes I'm standing in, Samuels. If my pockets are lined, we don't need to speak again.
No, I'm not giving you a penny.
Then I.
You'll have to give me a couple of days.
Not a problem. I'm not in a rush.
I found it. This is what I wanted to show you, Helen.
What is that, dear cousin? Your old sketchbook from when we were young. You were quite the artist. I suppose I was. I wish I hadn't given that up on now.
You could always start sketching again.
I wouldn't know where to start. But besides, there's not too much money in the art world anyway.
I suppose not.
Tell me, don't you think this has gone on long enough? Tell me!
Oh,
what's happening to you?
This is the sketchbook that belonged to a cousin. There's still no clues as to what happened to it. The final page of that letter, it is still missing, and I can't find it anywhere.
You've got to stop this. You've got to stop all of this
now! Stop! You don't understand. I can't. She's trying to tell me what happened to
it. Nobody is trying to tell you anything.
She is. She's here. From the moment I picked up that letter, I could feel her energy. She's trying to tell me something. You think I'm mad?
I didn't say
we
that.
We didn't have to.
My wife says a 100-year-old ghost is trying to tell her something. That didn't sound mad at all.
Don't mock me.
I'm not trying to mock you.
You must listen to me. She's trying to tell me what
about what?
Timmy, about what? What could she be trying to tell you? She wrote a letter. She killed herself. The end. There's no more to the story. Put it out of your mind. Whatever happened here is now out of our control.
I don't think she killed herself. I think she was murdered. I was thinking, what if the letter was a fake? What if she died and someone wrote the letter to make it seem like she killed herself?
And then they waited 100 years for someone to stumble upon it in this dusty old attic. Who then? If I'm to go along with this idea that she was murdered, who did it?
I think the cousin. She seems pretty unstable when you read the letter.
A letter you're claiming the cousin wrote herself. Surely she wouldn't have put herself in the letter if she had done it.
Fine. The husband then. It has to be him.
You're clutching at straws. It could be anybody. You don't know anything.
You're right. I don't know anything. I didn't ask to find that letter, and I didn't ask to be haunted.
So we're calling this natural haunting now?
Yes! I saw her. I saw the woman who wrote the letter. It's the truth. You weren't here, and there was this clock chime, and there was this tapping noise, and I looked around. I couldn't find anything. And then I turned around and there was this woman. Just for a moment, she stood looking straight out at me. Poor thing was as scared as I was.
When did you start wearing that? The necklace, when?
A day, maybe 2 days. I thought that if I tried to bond with her, tried to find ways to communicate
with her. So you're dressing as her now, is that it?
No, it's... She's trying to tell me what happened here. If I can figure it out, then this whole thing will just go away.
This only exists in your mind. There is no ghost.
You'll see, Callum. When I get to the bottom of what is going on here, you will see.
Is my wife going to find out?
I've not said a word yet.
Look, I already told you I'm working on getting you the money.
You said that yesterday. And the day before that. And the day before that!
Look, I'm doing the best I can under the circumstances. Why can't you just leave us alone?
You'd like that.
Of course I would!
So then make me disappear and give me what I want! Either that, or your wife will find out why you've been giving her all those gifts!
Listen very carefully to me, Helen. You will have to wait 2 more days. I just can't put my hands on it, and it takes time. And once you have it, you'll leave and never return. If you do, I'll...
Do what? What is it you'll do exactly?
Is there something the matter? I can hear you shouting from outside.
It's just a friendly debate, that's all. It's nothing. Really?
It didn't sound like nothing.
Everyone is fine, honestly.
I suppose I'll...
What is going on? You're going to tell me.
As I said, it was nothing.
You may say it's nothing, but I say it's everything.
I know
you did. And there will be a price to pay.
Demi, what are you doing?
Nothing. I was tidying up. I found a letter opener.
What is it you were saying?
I didn't say anything.
You did. I heard you.
I told you I didn't say anything. You think I'm mad again?
You said something about somebody paying for something. I think this rest of moving house has got to you.
It's
and...
It's not that. It's more than that. I can feel her emotion with... attached, like... We're like... one.
Do you think you're... possessed? Is that it?
I think I don't know, maybe? If only I could find the last part of that letter. I know I'm to the point where she confronted him, where he admitted that Helen was blackmailing him. I know that he wanted to leave, but that is where the letter stops. I have searched this entire attic and there's still no sign of the missing page anywhere!
The last page of the letter is gone. Move on. Accept it. Your delusions will pass. You will come out of this attic and remember. Remember what we once had.
Too much for my husband, do you?
What makes you think that? All those arguments the two of you just seem to have.
I'd rather hope you get along.
I think it's just the stress he's under from the bank. I don't take anything personally.
Join me, dear cousin.
Don't mind if I do that.
I was glancing at your old sketchbook earlier and I saw a sketch I've never seen before. Is it new?
No, that can't be. I've not sketched in there for years.
Are you absolutely positive?
What was it a sketch of?
It was... You know, I suddenly can't quite recall. Would you go and get it for me so I can show you?
I won't be a moment. What have you got there? Answer me!
Nothing. I thought you weren't coming up here anymore.
You'd like that, wouldn't you? You'd like me to hide away downstairs, away from the secrets of the ghetto.
Go downstairs, I'm busy.
I thought, sometime back, you were trying to hide it from me, but now, it's so obvious. But I kept pushing and pushing and pushing and pushing the idea away, pushing it! To the back of my brain.
So what are you accusing me of? Now am I meant to have killed a woman at the turn of the 20th century? Is that what you're saying?
That is the last part of the letter in your hand right now, isn't it? You know exactly what is going on here. I've seen you looking at her. The ghost, you've seen the lady from the letter, haven't you?
You're imagining things.
Still denying everything.
Of course I deny it, it's impossible. I mean, it should be impossible. I think everything that's been going on this past month is impossible.
How many times have you seen her?
4 times.
And then, do you know what she wants?
I've always known what she wants. Believe me, what I did, it was for your own good. Hiding it was the only way I could think of. But you just kept going and going and going.
Tell me!
I can't, I'm sorry, I can't.
At least, let me read the last part of that letter.
If you do, there's no going back for either of us. You'll know everything and you'll wish you didn't. Word, please, in private.
I think you've said all there is to say.
What is going on?
She knows about us. She knows everything.
I shall leave.
Drink your wine first. It'll be the last hospitality you ever get from me.
Listen to me. I know I behaved awfully, but if only you can find it in your heart to...
It's my fault. All of it. I'm just desperate.
Get! The last bus leaves at 18:50, and I suggest you're on it.
This is impossible. Is this some sort of sick joke?
That is no joke.
Did you write this? None of this makes any sense.
It all makes sense. Depending on your point of view.
I'm only going to ask you this once more. Did you write the letter, yes? Or no?
No, I didn't. You did.
Wasn't
it? Look at it. It looks pretty new to me. It's as white as a sheet, not stained. Both pages were.
But it said she died when the chimes rang in 1900.
As the bells ring in 1900, they shall be the last I ever hear.
I know what it says.
You really have forgotten, haven't you? 1900, 7 o'clock, 7 o'clock in the evening. And the bells ring at 7 o'clock. They shall be the last you'll ever hear. Look at the name on the letter. It's your name.
Demi, listen to me. I know I should have known this.
Trump! Dick! Trump! Dick!
even in my head that wearing Victorian clothing.
Only because that's what you wanted to see. You read 1900 and assumed that they were Victorian. But in truth, it was us. This whole story has been our story. That's why you felt such a connection with this lady. She is you.
No. How would I forget something like this?
Because you couldn't live with what happened next. I didn't know what you had done to Helen's drink.
Lady that I see, that we see, who is she?
That's the new owner of the house. I don't know exactly how it works. Sometimes we see her, sometimes we don't.
I remember now. I remember what happened. I remember how your actions caused us to die.
And that's why I've tried to save you from this moment. The events of that night drove you mad. You couldn't cope. Your body perished like mine. But we continued. You built a wall to protect yourself. You were better. I can help you build that wall again.
To forget and be happy.
We can be.
And what's with all this crap about us moving houses?
We are moving on. In a way, it isn't fair to the new owner. Maybe she can make happy memories here too, like we once did. It's time to move on. Come with me, Demi.
Move on where? To the next life.
We will be back to how we were. Look at how angry you are now. Does remembering it all make it better? No, it's just pain. Leave it.
I may hate you for what you did, but I can't.
You say them. I can help you forget again.
Never. Never forget. Never forget. Never forget.
Tell me, you can't be angry with me for all of eternity. You will one day feel as you did, I'm sure of it.
Never forget. Never forget. Never forget that you did.